Welcome to sunny Somerset in the middle of a summer heatwave. This is Minehead, a buckets and spades sort of town, with all the attractions of the English seaside. Fish, chips and ice cream, old fellas in straw hats, socks and sandals. Gracing the seafront esplanade is a traditional English seaside hotel. Jolly window boxes and Nell, the friendly dog. Only Foxes is a hotel with a difference. Nearly all the 60 staff have learning disabilities. Most of the time, things run pretty smoothly. But occasionally, there's rumpuses. Rouse.
Listen, literally, if this carries on, we're not making any bread.
And there's reprimands.
Look, I really mean this now. You come into my kitchen to learn. Keep your love lives out of my kitchen, yeah?
Welcome to the summer season at the Strangest Hotel in Britain. At Fox Hotel, the staff are students who spend 3 years here learning the hotel trade. This is Sophie, a first year. This term, she's on duty in the kitchen, helping prepare meals for the hotel guests.
Right, what we need is to get a metal spoon without holes this time.
Okay, calm down, you.
Me calm down, you need to calm down.
Well, you calm down, I am not.
Yes, you are.
I am not. Sophie, where to start? Completely in your face, yeah. Completely off the wall.
No talking to you, little
fag. You're not talking to me?
Yes, yes. You little fag, you little big rat.
The fact that she is so in your face, that's what's so challenging about it. And she wanders off. Whenever she wants. She does what Sophie does, what Sophie wants to do. Completely. And she winds people around her little finger half the time. I mean, like, she really does.
Excuse me, don't worry, you little kitty.
So, should we get some tea towels?
Martin wants his tea towels, but Sophie is still very much learning the Fox's way. This can have its frustrations for her kitchen colleagues.
She gets distracted. She goes off with all the will in the world to go get the tea towels. But she sees something interesting or exciting or something, she goes off with that.
Foxes celebrates its students' achievements. Every year, another 16 graduate, and the hotel walls are lined with photos of award ceremonies. This is excellent news for Sophie.
Oh my God!
There's a three-course lunch to prepare, but you wouldn't know it.
Oh my God!
Maybe she's cleverer than we think, and she's actually skiving. She wants us to believe. Exactly. Yes. Yeah.
15 minutes later, mission accomplished.
Thank you.
Fox's 52 students rotate each term through housekeeping, dining room, and kitchen duties.
Right, we've got the RAF. For lunch, approximately 20 people, yeah?
The hotel was set up 10 years ago by Maureen Tyler Moore and Sue Jenkins, the hinge and bracket of special needs.
Whoever it is who organises our lives from above, whatever you want to call him, God or whatever, they had decided that something like we do was needed, and they had a look round and they saw these two silly old bats down there and they said, they'll do. And they just made us do it.
Well, having the menopause helped.
Foxes is the only residential training hotel for people with learning disabilities in the country.
They work very hard. It is not
a place to come for like a holiday camp.
And it's a huge shock to a lot of them before when they've been, if they've been living at home with all the for all the best reasons in the world, a lot gets done for them, and then they have to suddenly go and do it all for themselves and do a job and learn. I mean, it's really quite something. They do,
takes
they
it
do
out well. Of them. When well. They first start training, they do about an hour and they're tired. They can't do anymore.
Every year, 900 guests come to Minehead to stay at Fox's. This is Tom. He's come to spend a week in the sea air. Like Fox's guests, Tom has his own learning disabilities. Tom is a Fox's old boy who graduated 5 years ago. Now he checks in like any other guest.
Welcome, Mr. Rose.
Did you have a good trip?
Yes, thank you.
That's good.
Have you eaten?
I haven't eaten.
You no. haven't eaten. Are you starving hungry?
Yes.
Right, well, Francis will take you up to your room.
Yes.
And then you'll have to come down to the dining room.
Okay.
And we'll give you some supper.
Yes, okay. All right.
Okay. Francis, would you like to take Francis to the box club?
I will.
Yes. Yes.
Right this way. Love is here.
Yes.
Please, sir.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sir.
Under the watchful eye of Fox's madames, Tom tucks into some late night dinner.
Mmm. This is good. Mmm. Good lasagna. Facial hair. The food gets into it, but I like this style I have. This sort of Victorian look. When I was doing waitering, we had to wear bow ties.
You probably quite like that though, didn't you?
Yes.
Don't you have a bit of tie collection?
Yes, I do. Ah, I've actually brought one with me to wear sometime. 70s bow tie. Now, isn't that what you call 70s?
Welcome to Fox's Hotel in Minehead. A unique training hotel where people with learning disabilities are trained for work in the catering trade. This can sometimes get a bit messy. Martin's been a Fox's chef for 5 years. Today he's coaching Stuart in the finer points of a bacon and a breakfast.
Yeah, mate. Put it in that, mate. Oh, you stopped it from about a mile high.
Oh, joy.
But not drop you from that high.
Yeah.
You'd do the same thing, wouldn't you? You'd go all over the place.
Oh, joy.
Okay.
Next door, Tom enjoys his first Fox's breakfast as a guest. He used to be doing the waiting, now he can sit back and do the eating.
Put your fried egg on the plate, fried bread on it. Oh, I'm stewed.
Oops, sorry.
Today, Tom and some other guests are off on a Fox's day trip. He's donned his black watch tartan blazer for the occasion.
I wouldn't mind marrying a girl from Hawaii. A nice Polynesian girl.
Oh.
Yes.
Right.
Then she could do. Then she could do the Hawaiian dancing. Oh yeah, I love that. Going bow bow wow wow wow. Yes. Yes. Oh yes.
Back at Fox's, there's the post-breakfast lull. This is the chance for students to catch up and chat. But if the staff aren't on their toes, a lull can become an eternity.
Breakfast time's over now, isn't it? So you've got 2 minutes to eat your breakfast and then come back to the kitchen, okay?
See your idea, thank you, Matt.
Yeah, 2 minutes.
Right,
right.
This is what we need.
You're 2 minutes. Thank you.
2 minutes.
Yes, thank you.
Deal?
Deal!
Good.
There's Fox's time. And then there's Sophie time.
You've had 1 minute, you've got 1 minute left.
Okay. Right. Hey, do that!
Because I tell you what you've got to do, you've got to put your rolls in the oven.
Oh boy!
So hurry up!